In this video, I'm gonna show you the full setup on how to play Def Jam Fight for New York on PC. We're gonna be using the PS2 emulator PCSX2, and I'll guide you through the whole process even if you don't have the emulator with you, and the best settings for this game. So the first thing we're gonna do is download the emulator itself, and it's available here on this website. I'll put the link on the description of this video. And right here on the main page, you're gonna click where it says Latest Nightly, and then click on Download for Windows. This tutorial is for Windows PC, so this is the version we're gonna be using here. So click on that to download to your computer. So the emulator file is a zip one, and you're gonna have to extract this, and you can use either WinRAR or 7-zip. I'm personally gonna recommend using 7-zip. I'll put the link of that on the description too. So download and install that. And once it's in place, you're gonna right click on the PCSX2 file, select 7-zip or WinRAR, depending on what you have, and then click on Extract here. Now these files will show up, and you can go ahead and delete the original zip file. We're not gonna need this anymore. And before starting anything else, first we have to create a portable file on this folder so that we have all the emulator folders on the same place. First thing you're gonna do on the window folder, you're gonna click here where it says View, and make sure that this box is enabled, the file name extensions. Click on that, and by doing so, you're gonna see the extensions of all the files in here. But what we have to do here is anywhere on this folder, you're gonna click on the right button with your mouse, and then select New, and then you're gonna select the text document file. So now, you're gonna erase everything that's in here, and the name of this file has to be portable.ini. Exactly like this. Now go ahead and press Enter, and it's gonna ask you if you are sure to change this. Go ahead and click on Yes. Now we can start with the installation. So double click on this PCSX2.ex file, and it's gonna show up the setup wizard, and you're gonna see all of these folders in here. That means you did this right. So now on this setup wizard window, we have a few options here to change the language of the emulator and also the theme as well. I'm gonna go ahead and start with the default one. So when you're done, click on Next. Now we have to select the BIOS folder. And because we made that portable file, it is this folder right here. But you can go ahead and click on Open BIOS folder, and it's gonna take you there. This is the folder where the emulator is going to scan for the BIOS file that is required for this emulator to work. So I went ahead and dropped the BIOS file that I have with me, and usually this BIOS file comes in this .bin format like this, and this BIOS is also copyright protected, so I cannot show you here on the video where to get it because it is against YouTube's guideline. So you're gonna have to find this on your own, and there are a bunch of BIOS files out there, a bunch of different versions, and all of them will work just fine. It does not have to be the one that I have in here. So now back on the setup wizard, with the BIOS file in place, you're gonna click on Refresh List, and if you did it right, you should see the BIOS file in here. So now just click on it once, and then select Next. Now we have to select the folder where we want the emulator to scan for your game. What I like to do here is go back to the PCSX2 folder, and I like to create a new folder here called Games. And this is where I'm gonna be placing the games files, but this can be anywhere on your PC. And once you have that in place, click here on Add, and you just have to navigate to the folder where your games are gonna be. I'm gonna select the games folder I came up, so click on that once, and then click on Select Folder. Now it's gonna ask you if you want to scan this folder recursively. That means that if you have a folder inside the one you picked, it's going to find the games in there as well. So go ahead and click on Yes, and you can also add multiple folders too. It does not have to be a single one. And once you're done, click on Next. Now we have to set up the controller. And this emulator has an automatic mapping function. That means that it's going to find the controller that you have, and it's going to do the configuration for you. And you can also use a keyboard as well, but this emulator supports pretty much all the controllers out there from PlayStation and Xbox, and even third-party controllers too. So what you have to do here is, if you don't have your controller plugged in, go ahead and do that right now. And when you do that, when you click on automatic mapping, you should see your controller here. In my case, I'm using a Xbox controller, so it's showing up as this option. So all I have to do is click on this one, and the configuration is pretty much done. And if you're going to use a second controller, you just have to do the exact same thing as well. There is also a more detailed controller configuration on the emulator. I'm going to show you that in a bit. And when you're done, click on Next, and we're pretty much done with the setup. So now just click on Finish, and just like that, the emulator will appear here. This will be a good time to subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video. For the more detailed controller configuration I talked about, here on the emulator, you're going to click on Settings and then select the Controllers option. And on this window, you're going to click on Controller Port 1, and here you can do the individual mapping of your controller if you want, and also choose the automatic mapping configuration again. Now, to add the game on the emulator, in my case, I choose the games folder, right, as the scanning folder for the emulator. So this is where I'm going to be placing the game file. And usually PS2 games, you're going to find them on the disk image file like this one, a .iso. And just like the BIOS, I can't show you here on the video how to get the game. You're going to have to find that on your own as well. And when the game is on the right folder, you're going to go back to the emulator and click on Scan for New Games. And just like that, the game will appear here. Now we're gonna tweak the emulator settings for this game so that we can get the best performance and graphics too. So on the game, you're gonna click on that with the right button on your mouse and then select Properties. By doing so, this window will pop up. And the first stop for us is on this emulation tab right here. On this window, under the system settings section, you're gonna click on Enable Fast CDVD and CDVD Precaching. These two settings will help with all the loading times of this game. It's gonna be a bit faster with these two turned on. And now, right below that, on frame pacing, you're gonna click on Optimal Frame Pacing. This will help with the input lag on this emulator. Now with this finish, you're gonna click on the Patches tab, and you're gonna turn on the widescreen patch for this game. So just click on the little box here where it says Enable, so that the game plays on a 16:9 aspect ratio, which is what we use on modern TVs and stuff. Now head over to the Graphics tab, and the first option, Renderer, the best video renderer for this game is the Vulkan, because this one fixes the vertical lines problem that this game has on the cutscenes. So if you have this showing up, go ahead and select Vulkan. But if for some reason this render is giving you problems like a black screen or something like that, come back here and select Direct 3D 11. This one is also good, but this will not fix the vertical lines issue. Now right below that on Adapter, you can go ahead and set this on default. You don't have to change this unless you have a dual GPU setup. If that's the case, you're gonna click here and select your main GPU. Now, right below that on Display, on Aspect Ratio, click on this one and select the widescreen 16:9 because we activated the patch right here, remember? Now, still here on Display on the very bottom, you're gonna click on the Anti-Blur option. That's all you gotta do here for Display. Now head over to the Rendering tab, and the first option, Internal Resolution, this is the one that's gonna make the most difference on this emulator. By increasing the resolution here, your game is going to look much better. But if you do increase the resolution, that's going to require more of your PC. In that case, that's going to require more of your GPU. In my case, I'm using a RTX 3060, which is more than enough for this emulator, and it can also play modern games as well. So if you're looking on upgrading your GPU or just check another PC component, click on my affiliate link that is showing up on the screen right now. Now, after this setting, you're gonna click on where it says anisotropic filtering. Click on this one and select 16x. This will make the game look better and it has minimal impact on performance. Now, still here on the rendering tab, you're gonna click on this box where it says manual hardware render fixes. By doing so, you're gonna see these two tabs showing up. And you're gonna click on the first one that says hardware fixes. And what we are about to change here is this skip draw range setting, because there is a problem on this game. Characters will have this ghost or glow effect around them. And one way you can fix that is on the skip draw range. On the first value, you're gonna type right here 11. And I've seen some people report that they had to set both values to 11. Otherwise, they would get a bunch of flickering issues and stuff like that. So you're gonna have to test this on yourself. That's pretty much all the settings you have to change here. So go ahead and click on close. And to start the game, you just have to double click on the name and the emulator will start. I have many videos like this on the channel covering how to install and play games on PC with the best settings for performance and graphics. So if you like what you saw, don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and as always, I'll see you soon.